This is Mission Control Houston. A team of flight controllers continually watch over the International Space Station from here and other centers around the world as the complex circles the Earth every 92 minutes at an average altitude of 260 statute miles. These flight controllers also assist the crew of six aboard the International Space Station that make up the Expedition 32 crew. That crew includes Commander Gennady Padalka and five flight engineers, Sergey Revin, Joe Acaba, Yuri Malenchenko, Sonny Williams, and Aki Hoshide. It's been another busy week for these six crew members aboard the station. Two of the crew members started their Monday with a little walk, a spacewalk, or extravehicular activity, that is, as Expedition Commander Gennady Padalka and Flight Engineer Yuri Malenchenko spent 5 hours, 51 minutes prepping the outside of the Russian segment for a future scientific laboratory and adding additional panels on the Zvezda service module to better protect it against potential impacts from micrometeoroids. It was the 163rd spacewalk in support of station assembly, maintenance, and scientific work, totaling 1,027 hours and 38 minutes. Padalka has conducted 9 EVAs in his spaceflight career for a combined duration of 33 hours, 6 minutes, and Malenchenko 5 EVAs totaling 30 hours, 5 minutes. U.S. astronaut Sonny Williams and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide will continue the preparatory work for the new Russian lab by routing some cables necessary for thermal and power and swap a bulky main bus switching unit, one of several power relay avionics boxes on the long truss backbone of the station. They also will remove and replace a failing camera on the mobile base system. Along with astronaut Joe Acaba, they've spent the week preparing for that EVA scheduled for Thursday, August 30th, by checking out their spacesuits and spacewalk systems in the U.S. Quest airlock. Additionally, this week, Hoshide worked inside the Japanese Kibo laboratory preparing its unique airlock and robotic arm for experiment operations as the systems interface through a laptop computer. He also talked about his voyage with a television program sponsored by TV Asahi, showing host Ayaka Ogawa around Kibo while talking about life in microgravity. Midweek, the station's altitude was boosted to a record average height above the Earth when the European Space Agency's automated transfer vehicle, Eduardo Amaldi, fired its thrusters on two strategically timed burns to increase the ISS's apogee by 8.7 statute miles and perigee by 3.6. The result placed the station in an average orbit of 260 statute miles. This is the highest average the station has ever been and sets the stage for the departure of three crew members in mid-September and the arrival of the next Russian Progress supply vehicle on Thursday, November 1. Experiment work has been embedded throughout the week's schedule each day, with focus being on the flame experiment known as BASS for burning and suppression of solids. The last in a series of samples were tested by Sonny Williams in the controlled environment of the Microgravity Sciences Glove Box on behalf of the ground team in Cleveland, Ohio. Further experimentation in support of BASS will now wait a few months until additional samples can be launched to the station. The binary colloidal alloy test, or BCAT, took center stage for part of Joe Acaba's week as he provided the on-orbit hands for the Canadian investigators in helping study nanoscale particles dispersed in liquid. Here on the ground, these particles are commonly found in paint, electronic polishing compounds, and food products. This study continues to collect data in hopes of development of new insights into this important material process. Expedition 32's seventh crew member, Robonaut, performed some intricate tasks on various task boards in the Destiny Laboratory to demonstrate its ability to be commanded from the ground in exercises that could assist crew members on orbit with hand-intensive activities. These included manipulating needles and knobs, similarly to how astronauts would work with them. Testing included use of Robonaut's vision recognition software to determine if the tasks were completed successfully. Further Robonaut activities are planned for Monday, attempting to grab a handrail and using a wipe to clean it as well. Be sure to follow Robonaut and its activities out on the Twitter account located at @AstroRobonaut. All crew members collected human research samples, urine and blood, for ongoing study of how the human body reacts and adapts to the long-term exposure to microgravity. These samples are returned to Earth for evaluation and developing countermeasures to maintain a healthy environment on board. Friday, Commander Gennady Padalka and Flight Engineers Sergey Revin and Joe Acaba enjoyed their 100th day on the space station and 102nd day in space. And over the weekend, all six crew members will get some time off to talk to their friends and families. They'll also perform some routine housekeeping chores as usual. Next week, the focus will be, of course, on the preparations for Sonny Williams' and Aki Hoshide's spacewalk planned for Thursday.